They fought only twice, but the tie-breaking grudge match never happened.
Today I'm announcing my retirement from professional boxing.
You know what this is, Razor? It's a video game. They want to put you and Kid in the game. All they do is videotape you throwing a couple punches, voice record you. I'm going to kill you. Except in a white guy's voice, because they don't want to scare anybody. Guys,
it's going to be a little bit, there's always going to be a little parody to it, because the audience will go, come on, we've seen you enough. So you do a little homage to that, then move past it, and that takes the onus off of it, if you know what I mean. And then everyone's expecting this kind of magical brawl at the end. You don't want to let that down. But what really makes it is there's a lot of acting in the movie, a lot of comedy, a lot of pathos, and brilliant performers. So it's one of those things where Bobby or I don't have to carry it all on our back. Everyone has a moment in this movie.
Won't be in the same light heavyweight class.
No one's choreographed more fight movies in cinema history than Sly Stallone. And so I would be an idiot not to at least ask him for some help and for some guidance. And he was very giving. You know, he was very respectful of me that, you know, this was my film, but I couldn't have done it without him. He was a great partner.
Well, you know, to me, I'm always in school in this life. I learn things from every co-star I have, good, bad, and ugly. You know, it doesn't matter. But when you get an eclectic group like this together, it makes you really excited to see what we can do with little moments in time, whether it's an ad lib or improvising something or whatever. I mean, you've got Alan Arkin also. I mean, he's a comedic genius.
30 years after their second fight, Kid McDonough and Razor Sharp get ready to go at it again. This is the moment.